lot of questions that we get is, what is digital printing? And that's a great question. So I wanted to take you back into our digital print room and kind of talk about that and show you how we print digitally. Kind of think about your stuff as like a copier, how you would send a file from your computer straight to a printer like you'd say you had at home. It's kind of the same thing that we have here, but on a larger scale. We call these printers Indigos. An Indigo printer is these things right behind me that print off these images extremely fast and onto a material that's going through the machine, and I'll show you that right now. Here's some of the stuff that he's printing off the machine now onto a roll. This is how it comes off printing. They go through here. Okay, starting to do that. So he's starting to print, you can kind of see it moving. Yeah, it's pretty cool how that whole thing works. So we have two of them. We have one over here. And then we have one over here. These printers are called HP Indigo printers. They're a special type of printing process that they put together, and it's all through electricity. And the file comes from the computer, and the computer sends it to our printer here, and then it starts printing off the images as we tell it to print. And I'm gonna show you everything inside of it and how it does it and what we're looking for when we're printing. And another thing that's really cool about these printers is they can go from one job to the next without stopping. We just have to set up the files, and after it's on there, we can just keep printing every job from one job to the next. And that's one really cool thing about this machine. Unlike how the old traditional style of printing was done, they have to sit there and man up a job, and it takes hours and material and a ton of time to do these things, where now when it's doing it, it makes these jobs come by really quick, so we're able to get your jobs out even faster than we would before. It's a pretty cool way of doing things. And another thing that's really nice about it is the waste is very, very minimal. We've saved a ton of time and material by going to this style of printing method. It's been really, really great, and we're super excited to keep expanding on in this type of printing. I'm gonna show you the inside and actually how this whole entire thing works. It's very interesting. They created this technology in Israel. HP, like the printers or the computers that you have at home, bought this technology, did a huge job and a great job supporting it. It's a pretty cool system in how they do this, and I'm gonna show you how that works right now. So I'm gonna open this up, and inside here is the print engine. What happens is from up here, you can kind of see up here, there's a laser writing head, and I know it's kind of hard to see, but you can kind of see up in here, where it goes and it images down onto this drum that goes around here. Okay, and from the drum, it images in a positive charge. And whatever's positive, the ink will stick to, and whatever's negative will wash back down, all the way back down into these tanks down here. And I'll show you that real quick. It washes back down in these tanks. So whatever's positive, it sticks to. So this ink gets drawn all the way up into these little pieces right here. And this lays down ink onto the drum. And like I said, whatever was positive sticks to it, and whatever's negative drops back down in there. So then what happens is we'll print yellow, we'll get put on there, and then we'll put magenta, and then we'll put cyan, and then we'll put black. And if we're printing with clear or silver, we'll put a white layer on there as well. And each individual piece right here is showing different ink colors on there. Okay, we can print up to 7 different colors. We have yellow, magenta, cyan, and black. Okay, and you see these other colors here. We can use some of these other colors like orange and violet. If you have a very specific color you're trying to hit, we can use those colors in here to create a closer look to a Pantone that you might give us. And we have some other videos on there about color and the color spectrum that might help you with that as well. And then, like I said, when we use silver or clear material, we use white ink on here. And this is our ink systems. What happens is it lays everything down onto this drum, and an electrical charge happens where it takes it from here and it jumps it down to the substrate that runs through the machine down through here and out. And it does this really fast. Everything gets held into place. Like, you think about if you hold an electrical line and your hand grips and you can't move it, it's kind of the same theoretical process that happens where this ink gets held into place And when it gets put onto paper, it holds the registration perfectly. So every single label or sticker that gets printed off these machines gets printed with perfect registration. There's no movement, there's no fuzzy look to it. And whatever art file you send us is exactly how it's going to print. That's why we talk about art files, and when you send us a file that has pixelations on it, this will print it out as a pixelation. It shows it exactly how you guys have it. That's why when we ask for art files, we like PDFs and AI files and all these different things. And we'll have another video about how to use art files and what we prefer and all those different types of systems that we use to make sure that your art files work. But with this press that we're talking to today, is very cool technology that they created when they did this. And it really helps us just get things done a lot faster. One other thing about this machine that's really cool, and what HP does and what Indigo does, is they manufacture these machines as carbon neutral. So there's a whole lot of things that go into being carbon neutral, and being a part of that whole community is something that we think is really great and we really want to be a part of. So I think that's really cool that HP and Indigo does this with these printers. Really has a forward-thinking process of the whole printing industry and also packaging industry. And it's a pretty cool thing. Another thing that's really cool, and we did another video about this, about color calibrations and how that actually works. Well, the machine right now is calibrating this substrate that we're printing on, this label material that we're printing on right now. And it's doing a calibration as we speak. So you can kind of see in here, and I'll kind of point closely, it's going through here and it's scanning these tiles as it goes back and forth. And it tells it how close it is to the master file that we gave it. So then when you guys give us a color file or a color build of something, then we can accurately represent the color that you're looking for off of your artwork that you give us. And we go through this iteration of color calibration every single job run. We do this over and over and over again to make sure that our press is at the highest calibration it can be, and it's to basically homeostasis would be another way to describe that. So this is color calibration. Thing that's going back and forth, as you see kind of swinging back and forth there, it's called a spectrophotometer, and that's reading the lab value. And like I said, we have another video talking about lab and talking about color calibration and talking about how we calibrate and what that actually means. So I highly recommend you guys check out that video about color calibration. So we just calibrated the press for this next job, and that took a few minutes. Now we're ready to print. Now this next job we have coming off here is, I think, 7 or 8 different copies. And we're gonna kind of go through, and you're gonna kind of see how it prints it off one after the other after the other. Unlike other styles of printing methods, this can do it like this, and this is where it really saves the material and it really saves the energy and the time of doing it this way. And it's pretty cool. And we'll kind of walk through and see how it does it. Kind of see here, it's printing 2 different copies at the same exact time, where we're able to gang jobs up onto the same exact web at the same time. And this job right here is being printed on a white VOP material, and I believe it's getting a matte laminate after this, but we'll talk about finishing in another video. But this is how it's printing and how it's coming off the web. All right, this is our home screen that we can show what jobs are queued up and what jobs need to be printed next. We're gonna see here another job pass through here when this one's finishing up, and then you're gonna see the next one coming through here. So you see the next one coming through on the other end. We just got done with the last job, and as the job's still running through, this one came through, and now we have a brand new job printing on the machine right here. And this one has 1, 2, 3, 4. This one has 4 different copies printing at the exact same time. So that's part of why it makes digital printing really cool, is we're able to do things like this and really make it an efficient process of printing and save as much material as we possibly can and not waste, because that's very important to us. So it's a pretty cool process that we have in place here. do the dance. Do the label dance.